So, we're going to be making a video about the Ottoman Empire. In this video, we'll be talking about the history, culture, and other unnecessary facts about the Ottoman Empire. From Sultan Osman I to Mehmed VI, this is everything you need to know about the Ottoman Empire.
The Ottoman Empire was located in these countries. It is one of the longest-lasting empires in history, lasting from 1299 to 1923. This means it lasted for almost 6.5 centuries. The empire first came into existence when a beylik in Bithynia, led by Osman I, began to take over the Anatolian Peninsula. Beyliks were essentially independent Turkish states formed after the breakup of the Sultanate of Rum.
This led to a massive conquest by the Ottomans or Osmanli, whose name comes from Osman I, as they took over a massive part of Eastern Europe, the Middle East, Anatolia, and North Africa. Their taking over was not always successful, however, as they were often invaded in the East by various Asian powers. The most disruptive example of this occurred in 1402, when the Uzbek warlord Amir Timur won the Battle of Ankara and took the Sultan at the time, Bayezid I, as prisoner, leading to an 11-year-long civil war known as Fetret Devri, literally the era of the change of regimes, as Bayezid's sons battled to become Sultan. Amazingly, this was the only major civil war in the Ottomans' history.
Speaking of Sultan Bayezid, he was probably the most impressive of all Ottoman leaders, as he doubled the land controlled by his empire. The rapid expansion of the Ottoman Empire carried on as they took over much of modern-day Serbia, Albania, and other Balkan states. Mehmed I was the first victor of Fetret Devri. His grandson, Mehmed II, also known as Mehmed the Conqueror, was able to gain control of the megacity of Constantinople, now known as Istanbul, at only 21 years old. This then became the capital of the empire, and it developed into a powerful trading stop for merchants and travellers.
Under the rule of Sultan Selim I, the Ottomans conquered much of Egypt, Lebanon, Syria, Palestine, and Saudi Arabia. At this point, the Ottomans had proven that they were the largest Middle Eastern empire the world had ever seen. Following Selim I, Suleiman the Magnificent would take the empire to its most powerful point, where new justice systems were introduced, making the empire much fairer. He was also a huge patron of the arts, and funded much of the Ottoman Empire's finest artworks. He then invaded the Austro-Hungarian Empire, Baghdad, and Mesopotamia. At this point, there were almost 20 million people living in the empire. To put that in perspective, at this point in time, the UK had around 4 million inhabitants, and the Holy Roman Empire had around 16 million.
Sadly, however, with any great empire, there is a drawback. The Ottomans' drawback was that the empire was very spread out, with constant attack from the Austro-Hungarians, Persians, and more. It was impossible to keep the army in a balanced place. This led to the empire slowly diminishing in size. Along with being on the losing side of World War I, a huge factor of the fall of the empire was that the UK, Portugal, Russia, as well as Luke Hannan Leia, finally managed to coordinate an attack at the same time. Under the rule of the 36th Sultan, Sultan Mehmed VI, on the 24th of July 1923, the Ottoman Empire fell, and the state of Turkey was founded, with Kemal Atatürk as its president.
The Ottoman Empire was run as an absolute monarchy, with the Padishahlar at its core. The Sultan also operated the military of the empire. The empire also had some, shall we say, interesting characters as Sultan. One example was Ibrahim, affectionately known as Deli Ibrahim or Ibrahim the Mad. He ruled from 1640 to 1648 and was obsessed with large women. Yes, you heard me right. And almost 300 of them drowned in the ocean when he realized that they had slept with other men. He also fed metal coins to his fish in his palace. As if that wasn't bad enough, he was also known for drenching his clothes, beard, carpets, and more with ambergris. He supposedly liked it for its scent, though I'm not sure why, since it's produced in the digestive system of a whale.
Some interesting dishes from the Ottoman Empire include molakma, a cheesy dish made with goat's cheese and cornmeal. Fodula is a meat dish made with goat or lamb, usually mixed with peas and carrots and served in a bread bowl. Finally, we have biryani, lamb prepared with spices, typically eaten with a flatbread, also known as ekmek.